Hey guys, I'm here again with Jamen today, and we're going to talk a little bit about shirt fabrics. So in a previous video, we talked about how to spot a good quality shirt, and I mean, I probably wear a shirt at least 200 days out of the year, so I think I'm sort of qualified to talk about this. Sure. I'm willing to bet you wear a shirt probably 300 days a year, at least.
Yeah.
You're more of a shirt guy. Yeah. So I think it's really interesting. Shirts in general, I can wear them and just really step up my style, you know, whether it's with kind of a jacket trouser look like this, obviously with a suit, or even if I'm just dressed casually with, I don't know, shorts and a shirt with my sleeves rolled up, it just elevates the style. So I think it's really important to understand how to make a quality shirt, but today, taking a little bit deeper dive into fabrics. But first, Jamen, in your opinion, what do you think makes a quality shirt?
Comfort. For sure, number one thing. Well, shirt is traditionally, like in European term, is considered underwear, actually. Mm-hmm. So it needs to be really comfortable, right? This old like Italian saying, like, well, nasce con la camicia, which means like born with a silver spoon, right? But they say like you're born with a shirt. That's how Italians say, like you're born with a silver spoon. That's how important shirt is.
Couldn't agree more. So on that topic, how do we achieve comfort? I mean, one is in the fit. If it's made well, that's great.
Sure.
We've talked about those before, but sure. I think one thing that is the fabric.
Absolutely. Yeah, I mean, between a mediocre fabric and a good shirting fabric, it's really night and day, I would say. Yeah. I mean, you can tell right away because it's directly in contact with your skin, right?
It brings up a question, and it's comes up a lot with our customers, and probably people in general are wondering, you know, there's non-iron shirts out there, and there's a problem with non-iron shirts. They're chemically treated, right?
Right. I mean, these days a lot of people are asking for that. If you pay attention, actually, any high-end shirting fabric would be very difficult to find like non-iron or even easy care options, because to achieve that, you like any fabric, you have to go through a chemical like liquid treatment to stiffen the fabric. And that really, I mean, I would say a little bit like fusing in the jackets or just ruin the fabric a bit, and it turns it into something synthetic. Even if it was originally like made by like 100% cotton or these natural fibers, it, you know, after this treatment, it just become a little bit dead, a little bit unbreathable. So, yeah.
Like you said, if you treat it with chemicals, it turns this organic, natural material into like a synthetic fabric. So you might as well just get something in a polyester or nylon blend. But you don't find that so much in the higher end luxury fabrics.
No.
And one that we're talking about today and want to introduce is Alumo. And this fabric is very interesting. They use a lot of very high-end cottons. And before we go into that, I mean, I think it's important to understand what makes a good cotton. And I think one thing is the staple of the cotton and the length of that fiber.
Right. Yeah, absolutely. So I think most people probably heard the term Egyptian cotton, which is one of the best. And the Giza 45 is the longest staple within the Egyptian cotton species. And actually, for example, like all Alumo shirt uses Giza 45. And that's actually the standard cotton they use.
So for example, I do know that the Super Lux collection, which is one of the most popular ones from Alumo, uses a minimum staple length of 3.5 centimeters. And that's already on the higher end of the lengths that you can find out there for the premium cotton length.
Right.
If we take one little step back though and talk about the staple length and cotton, if you look at the fibers and, you know, if you were able to pull this cotton apart, you can see the fibers almost like a lotus root, right? Just pulling apart, almost like cotton candy. You take those fibers and you spin them into a yarn. And think about this logically. If you have a shorter staple and you're spinning those into a yarn, that yarn's gonna be easier to just simply pull apart. Whereas if the staple is longer and they're spun together and you try to pull that yarn, it's gonna be actually more durable. So this makes a much more durable and long-lasting shirt.
Absolutely. I mean, the the stable length is really something, it's a quality that can only be told with time.
The other thing about the staple and the cotton that they're using is it's very fine. So the longer it is, the finer it can be. And we kind of want to do a little bit of like a blind test here. So I'm going to actually shut my eyes because we don't have a blindfold handy and touch two of these fabrics. And I'll just kind of describe them and feel them, cool. To see what they're like. So let's try this out.
All right. All
right. I promise I'm not peeking.
Let's try this one.
Okay, so I mean, I can feel it. It feels like a cotton. It's soft, but I don't know if it feels super fine. Can I feel the other one too at the same time? Let's feel the other one and compare them together. So I'm gonna hold them both in my hand. So if I'm comparing these two, this one somehow feels slightly denser. This one feels softer, but this one feels smoother. Somehow I'm probably leaning towards wearing this one.
Mm-hmm.
So, okay, I'm gonna open my eyes now.
Right. Sure.
Okay, so
yes, I mean you're right. I mean this is an Alumo.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely a more substantial fabric,
mm-hmm.
And it's got a, I don't know if it shows on the camera. It's got a very nice sheen.
Mm-hmm.
Although this is a poplin. So to be fair,
it should be lighter,
right.
Anyways.
So like poplin is generally a little bit lighter, and the texture is a bit more grainy.
Mm-hmm. We talked a little bit about the staple lengths, but also thread count and the finesse, or mm-hmm. the fineness is also something that's very important with shirts. You know, we just did a blind test and I felt a 120 thread count. It felt very smooth and soft, but I want to compare a 120 with a high thread count of say 200. This time, I want you to close your eyes, Jamen. So I've got the book here from Alumo, and I'm gonna pick one out and just fold it up and, you know, place your hand on it. I want you to feel it and explain and describe how it feels, and I'll give you another one to feel.
Okay.
And then let's talk about it after that with your eyes open. Okay?
All right,
I'm gonna go through here to... Okay, Jamen, hold your hand up. I'm gonna put this one in your hand, and I want you to feel that. So describe how it feels to you.
All right, so I know this is a poplin, very light, feathery. It's pretty fine.
Mm-hmm.
I can't tell the exact thread count, but it's pretty fine, but it's not the finest.
Okay, well, all right, let's see. Keep your eyes closed. So I'm gonna give you another one to feel here. Feel that one.
Right, so instantly, I mean, this is a very fine shirt. Absolutely. This would be at least over, I would say, like 160.
Okay, yeah. Keep your eyes closed. Let's do a third one, just for the sake of mixing things up here. Okay, so okay. Please
make it more
lift your hand up. Let's make it more challenging. Feel that one.
Mm. This one is super smooth.
So how does it feel?
I know you tried to, try to give me a challenge, but this to my hand still feel even finer. Well, at least like as fine as the last one, and definitely more smooth.
Okay, you can open up your eyes, and I will say this guy's a professional. I wouldn't expect other people to get that right, maybe not even myself, but in the order I gave him to you, I did try to maybe like mess with your head, mm-hmm. and pretend I'm gonna mix it up, but I did do it in order from 120 to 170 to 200 thread count.
Right.
So you felt that difference all along the way, and you're absolutely correct.
Okay,
yeah.
Great.
Well done.
I kept my reputation. That's good. This is absolutely real. I didn't know.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think that's very interesting that you could feel that just immediately, and even not together, comparing them one after the next after the other.
And think about this, your hand is actually the least sensitive part of skin compared to your body, right? Because your hands, you're touching all sort of rough things all day long, right? So your skin on your finger is very thick. So if your finger can feel that difference instantly, just imagine like how your neck, how your body would react to that, mm-hmm. to that difference, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. So I think we should explain a little bit what that means, that number, because super numbers in suiting and shirting mean something. And we should explain to them a little bit about that.
Sure. Well, it basically, it's the same meaning as in jacketing. The thread count basically means in 1 inch, how many threads there are in 1 inch of fabric. Which naturally, the higher the number is, the finer the fabric will be.
So which is one of the reasons why if there's 120 threads in a square inch versus 200, they're going to be smaller, they're going to be finer, they're going to be smoother and softer to feel.
Yeah.
And so this circle is back to the other interesting thing I thought, because as a thread count goes higher and higher, it is finer and finer. But the nice thing about Alumo is a lot of them, if not all of them, are actually 2-ply. Wow. And I think that's interesting. So in the spinning process, 2-ply means the yarn is spun. Well, it's spun into yarn, and then that yarn is double in ply and then woven into a fabric material. That 2-ply means it's going to be a little bit extra durable, a little bit extra crisp, and that in turn actually helps out a little bit with keeping a shirt slightly cleaner draping, a little bit less wrinkles. But of course, it will wrinkle. It's cotton. It's not steel. It's not metal. It's a cotton shirt.
But it's a good balance between the fineness and the durability, the sort of wrinkle resistance. And it's achieved by in a natural way rather than going through like chemical treatments.
But another really important part, other than the raw fiber itself, is actually how it's made into a yarn. And there's a lot of water involved with that milling process.
Yeah, of course. I mean, we all know like to process any fabric, you need a lot of water. And obviously, the water in Switzerland, as you can guess, it's one of the best in the world, one of the cleanest in the world. Alumo is the first shirting factory to acquire that OECO 1000 standard, which means literally the wastewater that they produce is actually even cleaner than the water that they originally take. So that's the level of quality and the level of sort of environmental responsibility that they have, which is quite impressive.
It is impressive, especially for a company that's over, I think, 100 years old. So it's very nice to see them changing with the times and understanding that they do have an impact on the environment, and they're trying to be as responsible as possible.
Yeah.
One of the ways we make our shirts is in one of the best possible ways, because when we make it, we want it to last. I think after learning more about Alumo fabrics and sharing that information, it's pretty clear to understand that this fabric is a quality fabric that not only feels luxurious and nice on my skin or my body, but those longer staples lead to a more durable, higher quality shirt at the end of the day.
Absolutely.
And this, in this day and age, being sustainable is not just a buzzword, but it's important because, like for example, if you have a few good shirts in your closet, it's very easy to choose which one to wear today. Rather, if you have a bunch of shirts and you get that one decision paralysis, or just the idea of just buying more and more and more stuff and then throwing it away. And it goes a little bit with our principles of, you know, buy less, but buy better.
Yes, absolutely. I think these days more and more people are getting fed up with the cheap products that you just, that's so like easy come, easy go, and there's no emotion toward it. I mean, you even never use it, never wear it. It's just, you buy something just because it's cheap, and you end up wasting more.
Mm-hmm. I hope this was helpful in terms of learning a little bit about Alumo fabrics and really what a quality garment is in the fabrics. Jamen, thank you very much for joining and sharing this with all of you guys out there. So hope you enjoyed it.
Bye-bye.
Thanks for watching.
Ciao.